live from Los Angeles. Welcome back to Good Morning La La Land. We are so excited to welcome the glamorous Christiane Seidel. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's been incredible to watch your journey on television. I mean, from four seasons of Boardwalk Empire, Godless, and now Foss and Vernon. This has been incredible. Tell us a bit about your journey.
Well, yeah, it's one of those things. It's like you never know where your journey is going to go. But in looking back, it's been, you know, I started on Boardwalk Empire as a possible one or two episode character, and then four seasons later I was still there and they never killed me off, which was an accomplishment by the Empire.
It's good not to die.
Yeah, most people kind of had some sort of death eventually, and that, yeah, one thing led to the other, you know. That's then how you start your relationships with casting directors, and then they call you in for other things. And I'm so grateful for, like, I've had you know, I started with a Martin Scorsese show, and then got Scott Frank, who's another Oscar nominated writer and director, and now with working with Sam Rockwell is just a dream.
Tell us about your role as Hannah, what it's like to play the other woman.
Yeah, that's interesting, right? Sometimes it's also fun to be able to be that kind of person in on a TV show or in a film, because in real life I'm not that person.
I love it.
Explore a different side of self.
Exactly. Yeah. But I generally, as an actor, I don't want to judge the characters, because in real life, I don't walk around making decisions while I'm judging and looking at myself. So, you know, we do things with all good intentions and we think we're doing the right thing. And then in hindsight, maybe we did make a big mistake. And so I go into this character trying to find something that connects me with her and something that makes me just figure out why she's doing that.
Well, certainly better to make the mistake on screen than in real life.
Yes.
Test it out. See how it goes.
We know the show's heavily biographical. But yes. What can we expect? What do you think, if audiences aren't familiar with the characters in the story, would draw them into it?
Well, definitely. So if you're not into musical theater and Bob Fosse and his life, it's a story about a really passionate relationship that brought both people on the forefront of a new way of doing musical theater, of films. And they had so much passion for each other, and there were so many things that went wrong in their relationship. We also don't know anything about Gwen Verdon, or the general public doesn't know much about her, and now she's being put in the spotlight that she was actually facilitating his career.
And nice. Yeah. Ooh, a lot of depth there. Was this the one role that you really, 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 really wanted throughout your career, and then you got the call that you got it?
Well, I didn't know this show was going to happen. I don't know about this person that I play, that she existed, or I don't know that this was going to come along. But I will say this, working with the team from Hamilton, working with the director who directed Hamilton, Tommy Kail, working with someone like Sam Rockwell. I've loved Sam Rockwell for so many years, and I've watched his journey, and it's just an honor.
Yeah.
Be on a set with him and Michelle Williams.
I mean, do you ever get nervous? You're about to do a scene with Michelle Williams and you're standing there, and are there ever times when you're nervous because you're working alongside people? I'm sure nervous working with you too, because you know,
you.
But it's true. But you know, how does that
Yes, of course, I'm nervous, but I also know if I start thinking about all these things from the outside instead of just doing my work, then I'm not doing my work justice. And then you can spiral into something that you're not happy with. So I just try to really just work with him as
try
a colleague. But he's also someone who is so giving as an actor and so present and there.
Which makes a huge difference,
Nice.
What would you attribute your success to, in addition, of course, being beautiful and talented? Is there something, a trait, a quality that you feel has been most responsible for your success?
Oh, I like that question, interesting. Well, I believe something that I thought was in my way probably became something that has helped me, which is that I speak several languages. And I started on Boardwalk being a Norwegian, so I did a Norwegian accent, which I was able to do because I speak Danish. And then on Godless, I played a German because I'm I speak German. So I definitely that has helped that I can fill those niches, I guess.
Yeah, how great.
You also speak baby, I've heard, right? So, yes. So tell us a little bit about that. I know you were pregnant. Actually on the set.
I was pregnant. I found out when I was in New Mexico shooting Godless, doing gun training and horseback riding, which you're not supposed to do horseback riding when you're pregnant. But I figured things out how to do, how to work around it.
You just strap you in.
I didn't tell anyone on set because it was so early. I was just so sick in the corner, sitting in the corner trying to fall asleep. Or not trying not to fall asleep.
Trying not to, yeah.
It was an interesting journey. But you know, Scott Frank, who's our writer director, he's a twin himself. And I found out in Santa Fe that I'm pregnant and that then I was pregnant with twins.
Wow.
And when I wrapped, the day I was done, there was a small chance I had to do more shoots in 2 months, and I knew that wasn't going to work. So I told him to warn him, and he was just, I mean, he couldn't have reacted any better because he's a twin. And I met his twin sister on set.
Oh,
nice.
How special.
He was like, oh my God, that's the best thing ever that you're having twins.
That's amazing.
What a nice experience.
How do you balance it all? How do you balance it all with the kids and work and life?
I don't know. I try and fail.
Exactly.
But I do, you know, I keep saying this. My husband is really such a trooper. He is my biggest supporter from day one when nobody else was there. And to this day, he's always, you know, he wants to make everything possible to be flexible, that when I can't be there, he's there. We have a babysitter. And we just try to put the puzzle pieces together.
It's that's amazing. Beautiful because, mm-hmm. you know, a lot of times in Hollywood, especially, they say women have to sacrifice something. They're going to have a successful career, or they have to sacrifice the family or sacrifice their relationships.
Yeah, that's because it's, and for me, it was a question, too. I wanted to be a mom. And as an actress, you think, or I thought, there has to be a moment that I have to wait for the perfect moment. But that will never happen. Right. So I just decided. Now's the time.
Don't you think Hollywood's changed a little bit, though? I mean, yeah. I remember sort of back in the day, it was taboo, don't tell anybody. Even when I was doing my show, Stella's House, they made me hide the fact that I was pregnant with boxes.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
It was, for the first few months. Yeah. And so, because they wanted the shows to be evergreen. But now I feel like it's completely different. And they actually, Hollywood really embraces it.
I think it's changing. I think there's still a long way to go because it's very hard also. It's not like you can bring your kids to set. Either.
Right.
Unless you maybe have your trailer and you bring your nanny and you have the whole setup. But
right.
I'm not saying there should. Well, I also come from Germany and Denmark where it's just inherent that everyone has kids and you can leave work at 3 p.m. to pick up your kids.
Isn't that nice, right? And, why don't we learn from that?
It's not possible, of course, on a film set, right? But that you just leave at any point in time. But it would be great if there were some sort of support systems that are in place.
On set, you mean like when you're actually working? Yeah.
I know it's a dream, but I know. And this is what you were saying. That's why many times, if you don't have the means, if you don't have the setup that you can just up and leave, then you can't work. You can't go to set because you can't bring your kids.
Well, you've proven, though, that you can have it all. Mm-hmm. I really, truly admire that and all the work that you're doing. Tell everyone where they can obviously find and follow your personal journey and catch your show on FX.
So they can find me on Instagram. At It's Me, Christiane, and Facebook, and then on FX, you can watch Fosse Verdon on Tuesday nights at 10 p.m.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more on Good Morning LaLa Land.